In this video, we're computing the derivative of the natural log of the square root of x squared plus 1. And I'm actually going to do this in two different ways. I'll start by doing it the best possible way, in my opinion, which starts by taking advantage of log properties. So we realize that the square root of x squared plus 1 is just x squared plus 1 to the 1/2 power. And then we remember logs have these really nice properties with exponents, where a log of something to a power is the same as if you brought that power out in front of the log function. Now, derivatives see right past constant multiples. In other words, I could just write that 1/2 out in front before I take the derivative. So now I have 1/2 times the derivative of the natural log of x squared plus 1. And this is going to require the chain rule because that's a function composition. So we differentiate the natural log with respect to its argument, treating x squared plus 1 as a single variable just for the moment. And the derivative of a natural log is 1 over its argument. So I have 1 over x squared plus 1. And then the chain rule says we have to tack on the derivative of the interior function, which is 2x here. And these 2s are going to cancel. And we're left with x over x squared plus 1. Now, if you don't see that log property simplification, things are a little bit more difficult. Now, if we're not going to bring that 1/2 down in front of this expression, we're going to have to use the chain rule on a function of a function of a function. So maybe I should emphasize in this expression that I have the natural log of this entire thing, x squared plus 1 raised to the 1/2 power. So the natural log function is the outermost function here. So we begin with the chain rule by saying that we have 1 over the argument of the natural log function. So 1 over x squared plus 1 all raised to the 1/2 power. Then we need the derivative of x squared plus 1 to the 1/2 power, which is itself a function composition. So we start by applying the power rule, and we get 1/2 times that inner function to the negative 1/2 power. And then we have to tack on the derivative of the inner function. So those 2s cancel out. And that x squared plus 1 to the negative 1/2 power, that's really just an x squared plus 1 to the positive 1/2 power in the denominator. I can then combine that with the one that's already there to get x squared plus 1. So we're left with the same answer, x over x squared plus 1. So I recently threw this problem onto a quiz in my calculus class, and the main point there is just that when you're dealing with natural log functions, you should be looking for opportunities to exploit those interesting exponent properties of logs. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.